globals are those variables where you can use them anywhere in entire your folder. In entire folder, you can use them anywhere. Okay? So, like say you have a document root folder, let's say. Right now, in our case, is tt underscore basic php. Right? This is our folder. Now, any file which is inside this, if it's a PHP file, if I have a super global, okay, then I can use that super global in any of the files inside that document root. So that is the reason we use super globals. Okay, now super globals are predefined variables. Okay, there is only one variable which, as Monali said, I mean, if you declare globally, you can use them everywhere. For that, we have one particular variable. Otherwise, everything is predefined. You cannot define super globals. Okay, so all super global variables are predefined. They come with PHP. You can't really do much about it. You can change those values, some of the super globals values, but not everyone's. Okay. So, the agenda is that super global variable is that variable which can be used across different files which are under the same document root. Like for instance, I'll give you an example. You log into Gmail, okay? Then you say YouTube. Then you say Google Drive. Do you have to log in every time? Once you log into Gmail, do you really have to log into YouTube and Drive? It is automatic, right? Right? So that is the reason. So super global variable is a reason which lets you log into YouTube and Drive automatically when you log into your Gmail. Because YouTube and Drive belongs to Gmail. Okay? So that variable which lets you to, you know, which lets you log into different websites like YouTube and Drive using Gmail, that variable in PHP's context is called dollar underscore session. Okay, it's a very, very important concept in PHP. One of the easiest. So session is a concept where you don't have to log in again and again. You log in once, I will store your information into session, then that's it. You don't have to again. You can navigate across the website using the same login. Let's say, again, take another example now. Take Facebook. Okay, you log into Facebook once, then you go to your different friends profile. Okay, so once you log in, you can go anywhere into Facebook, unless until it is restricted. Okay, there are some pages or some places in Facebook which are restricted, but once you log in, you can navigate across the entire website. You can go to anybody's profile, like it, comment it, and whatever you do on Facebook is against your own profile, right? Suppose you like somebody's picture, it gives your name over there. Okay, so Avinash has liked this picture, Avinash has commented, Avinash made this post. Okay, so you build an identity inside once you log in, and that is being handled by session. Okay, session is a very powerful concept. Now, another point. So session is a super global. Okay, because you log in only once, you log in on a single page, login page, but you can go to any page using that login. Okay, in the second instance, second example we have here is, you see sometimes remember me option, remember me, keep me signed in. You guys have seen this, remember me. If you remember, like, next time you don't have to again fill your information, all you gotta just click login, or keep me signed in will, you know, keep you signed in. How this is handled now? For that reason, we have another super global, which is dollar underscore cookie. Okay, dollar underscore cookie. Now what's the difference like? Dollar underscore cookie and session are the same. I mean, the functionality is the same. They both remember you. They both remember you. Who are you? What's happening? But session we have to maintain that session more secured. Okay, we have to maintain security in session, whereas in cookie you don't really have to maintain that security. So the only difference between cookie and session, okay, both are done on server side, both are PHP, but you can set an expiry date to your cookie using PHP, whereas sessions, that can also be set, but the default duration of a session is 20 minutes on idle. If you are idle, okay, session expires in 20 minutes. You see these bank websites? If you're idle for 5 minutes, or take IRCTC, the most popular one. If you stay idle for 5 minutes, what does it say? It says, please log in again. Right? That's being handled using cookie. Okay? So cookie and session are two global, super globals, which are used in PHP to remember your information so that you can navigate the entire website very easily. Right? Now, there's another instance here. You set your profile picture, right? You set your profile picture wherever. You set your profile picture in Tutor's Lightroom. I see most of the people don't have a profile pictures in Tutor's Lightroom. Right? But still, in Facebook, you set your profile pictures, Google Plus, Twitter, Tutor's Live, right? And in Naukri Monster, you upload your resumes, right? So, in SlideShare, you upload your slides. In YouTube, you upload your videos. So, everywhere the common functionality is upload, right? Everywhere the common functionality is upload. Whatever you do, you set a profile picture, you upload a video, everything is an upload. So, PHP has a super global which can handle these uploads. So, what are we uploading here? We are uploading files, right? So, that super global which is associated with uploads is $_files. Remember, everything is a caps, okay? Cookie, session, and files. Files, $_files is a super global associated with your uploads, right? Then another two important ones. Now, you guys know about forms, right? HTML forms. HTML forms, contact us form, login, registration, right? Now you submit. You submit your forms. There should be a means to collect the data, right? Because HTML cannot collect data. PHP can collect data. So to collect data from forms, we have two super globals in PHP. To collect data from forms, we have two super globals in PHP. Those are $_get, $_post. You guys know what post and get? HTML guys? Get and post? Yeah? Any idea on get and post? Post for send, okay. Get for get, okay. Great. No, that's not the right answer. So post and get. I mean, Praveen knows the answer. Whomsoever attended the front end development class, they know the answer. Come on, you had to say this answer. Praveen and Niranjan, I know you guys have attended. I don't know about Monali. Monali, did you attend the front end class? No. Okay. At least watch the videos. Come on, the classes are all free. You don't have to, you know, just spend your time, not money. But whatever it is. Okay, let that be. So every form is submitted in two ways. Okay, every form is submitted in two ways. Get is one method, post is one method. There are two methods to submit a form. So what get does is, get passes data through URL. Whereas post passes data through headers. Okay, this is exposed, whereas this is hidden to the user. Right? So now whenever you use a method, according to that method, if you are using get method in your forms, what is the relevant super global? If you are using get method. Yes, any idea? Any guesses? If you are using method get informs, what is that super global variable used to collect the data? Dollar underscore, remember, underscore. Dollar underscore get is the variable super global which is used to collect the data which is passed through get method. All caps, Praveen. Dollar underscore capital G, capital E, capital T. Okay. Now if you have post method, what is that super global used to collect data? Dollar underscore post. Right. So now how many are done with? We're done with session, cookie, files, get, post. And sometimes what happens is like people don't know what kind of method they are using when they are confused. But literally I never got confused with what kind of method I'm using with my forms. But there is another guy, request. Never ever ever use request. Okay. So what dollar underscore request does? Dollar underscore request, irrespective of what method you are using, it will collect data from the form. You use post or use get. And it has an additional advantage that it will give you your cookie data also. Instead of using dollar underscore cookie, it gives your cookie data also. But I won't teach you this because this is the most unsecured way of dealing with data. Okay? Never ever use dollar underscore request. I'm saying it because sometime later you may find out this, okay, dollar underscore request, it's very easy to use because I don't know how to write get or post. No, don't ever ever use it. Know your methods, know which variable to collect data. Alright? Then there is one more variable, as Monali pointed out, that the global declarations. Right? For that we have globals. Okay? This is a super global which is used to collect the global variables. If a variable is declared globally, to collect that dollar globals. Okay, there is no underscore here. We'll discuss this tomorrow. Alright. And the last of which is today's topic, which is dollar underscore server. This is our today's topic. So this is the last super global variable. So we'll be discussing this, and this in advanced PHP. This at the end of this course, this today, and this tomorrow. Alright? So now coming to the dollar underscore server. Why do we need this? What does this do? So dollar underscore server essentially gives you all the information about your server, where you are hosting your code, and the person who is accessing it, say remote. Suppose, you know, Praveen here is accessing my website from South Africa, let's say. So dollar underscore server will have all the information where he is accessing, what's his IP address, what's his machine, what's his operating system. And it will also give me what file he's accessing, when did he access that file, what time did he access that file. Right? Or let's say Niranjan is accessing a file. So it will tell me who is accessing my files, where my files are placed, what is that file, what time did he access that file. Okay, so why do we use dollar underscore server? So any ideas why do we use dollar underscore server? Is it helpful to us? Yeah, sometimes dollar underscore server is helpful to us. Let's see what kind of data this dollar underscore server has. All right. Shall we go ahead and see a program? You clear? Are you guys clear with that? Okay. Sravya, and I guess Abhinash understood it. I don't know about Sravya. Niranjan understood it. Rishmita understood it. Sohel, I don't know. Okay, cool. Alright, so let me share my screen here. So doc type, you guys can see the screen, right? HTML and inside head, I'll say title. Okay, I'll say attendance report here inside a div. Okay, always remember you have to place everything inside a container. Okay, always wrap it around a div. Now first let's build. Okay, let me just write it table assignment dot php. Right, so now here first table, table. Okay, you can use a border, border equal to 1, cell spacing equal to 0, cell padding equal to 5. Now here the first tier, what we had over there, we have first the, then here we have th. Okay, always remember write a table in a structured way like this. I'll show you. First is employee ID. Right? The next is his name. And the next is login time. And the next is logout time. And the last is adjust. Right? So let's see this. Localhost TT. This is the table. We can move this, we can style this, you know, we can do whatever we can. Now I told you guys to do one more thing. Okay, on top of the table here I'll put one more tr, I'll put one more th, I'll make a class equal to full right. Okay, here call span. You guys know about call span? Yes. So let's print today's date. So today's date is December 4th 2014. So let's see what this does. Okay, December 4th 2014. Okay, call span. I hope you guys know about call span. Call span is that span the entire data in a single cell. Okay, I gave 5 because I have to take the space of 5 and make it 1. That's why it's 5. Alright, good. So now coming to here, this is the curious part, tr. Now here td, let's copy. We have 5. We have 5. Alright. Now here echo dollar employee underscore ID. Alright, I take this, paste this. Is employee name, this is employee login, this is employee logout, and this is just a link. I told you guys to put just a link, a href equal to hash adjust. And now we have to declare the variables here. So here php dollar employee id equal to 1. dollar employee name equal to Sagar, dollar employee login equal to okay, this is including seconds. Alright, always use 24 hour format. That's a very, you know, very good notation. So here 16:05. Alright, now let's see what we can get here. Alright, this is what happened. Now, every time what can I do here? I'll just copy this. This is the first task we have. Tomorrow we'll make this dynamic. Right? So if I want to move this, let's say. Now let's style this. Let's style a little bit. Table width 100%. Right? Width is 100%. Now for body, width is 60%, margin 0, let's see, alright, let's come here. Now for this, what I do, margin top 100 pixels. Alright, so this sounds good, and for the first tr, okay, so here I'll give a class equal to first tr, first tr background hash f8 oops. Let's give it to second tier. Right, for pull right text align right. Right. So this is how I can style this, and you can change the variable. Now what I have to do if I change, if I want a next employee, let's say get to Nali 6 17. So all I gotta do is like change the variables. I'll go here, I'll refresh, yeah, you'll get to know that. So tomorrow we'll see how we can make this more dynamic, like, you know, not writing it statically like this using variables every time. But this is what I really meant when I told you to do a table assignment. Okay, are we clear here? Where ID? Okay, ID should be unique, class should be multiple, class can be multiple, but ID should be unique. You can use an ID on table because there is only one table. You can use ID on div. Let's say I'll say ID equal to table wrapper. Okay, I say ID equal to table wrapper. So you have to go through the old videos. Go through the front end development videos. You'll get to know. So your background hash f8. 0000. Right? It looks very, very mild, right? Let's use a very mild color. Actually, let's use something like this. Let's take this color. You guys know how to use inspect element, right? I don't have to explain you guys inspect element every time. right? So this is the table. Okay. Are you good? So tomorrow we see how we can make this dynamic using. So now you go through your assignments. Go back your assignments. Okay, your code. Yeah, I can understand. I don't know how much time you have put. We took only here 10 minutes to do this. Right?